beautiful people. So in today's video, we'll be talking about 10 ways to save. I'm not sure I'm going to mention up to 10, but then maybe this video is going to have a part one and a part two. So 10 ways to save money for your skincare products. Like, skin has really been our issues that people spend a whole lot of money. Like, buying skincare products is more like buying food in your day-to-day life. Now, no matter how bad or difficult or tough the economy is, a normal women of color would still want to get their skin back on track. So this is why I figure out a way to actually save money while you're trying to get your skin back on track. Like, this one is going to help you still get your skin back on track, but on a low budget, if you get what I mean. So if this is something you've been interested in watching, definitely do well to keep on watching. This is your first time here, you're highly welcome, and if you're a returning subscriber, welcome back to another video. Yeah, in today's video we'll be talking about saving money while using skincare product, like I said. Okay, so do well to leave me your video suggestions as well as your questions down the comment section. That way it's going to help with the recaps on Sundays. I really appreciate you guys for always coming through for our recaps, and I'm just grateful that I started this recap, because I noticed that a whole lot of people are really interested in recaps. So you want to do well to also leave me your questions down the comment section, and I'll definitely answer to it. Yeah, so without further ado, let's just dive straight into the video. Yeah, so our number one way to save money on your skincare products is buying drugstore. Like, there are a whole lot of people who are so keen when it comes to buying products that are expensive. They believe that if it's expensive, that means it's original. They believe that if it's expensive, that means it will work really, really well. You guys, there are so many affordable products out there that can really do the job amazingly. If you go out, like, you take yourself out for a window shopping, just run through their counters, you're definitely going to find something for your skin type. Instead of spending a whole lot of money to buy drugs, to buy skincare products, to buy from their brands, to order from eBay, like all them website and all them expensive skincare brands, you guys, you can actually do this the drugstore shop nearest to you. There are so many affordable drugstore products which I'm going to, like, you know, list out in another video, that will really, really help you grow your skin, get your skin back on track without having to spend too much. So our number two would definitely be skip toners. Now, why I say skip toners is that one thing we do not really know, especially those people that are not in the skincare industry, people who do not really know about skincare and all of that, they feel like if you have a toner, like, it's good to have. In fact, it's necessary to have a toner. I have people who feel like if they don't incorporate toner into their day-to-day skincare routine, they are missing out. No, you're not missing out, especially if you do not have an oily skin. If you do not have an oily skin, you don't necessarily need a toner. You guys, you don't need a toner. Toners are, like, mainly for you know, people with oily skin. The skincare brands, they know that, you know, introducing more products out there will really help people feel like, okay, if you incorporate all of these things, it's going to help, like, it's going to get your skin back on track. They won't tell you that. No, even if you walk to a supermarket, they will, like, the salesperson, they will definitely tell you, get a toner, it's important that you get a toner. No matter how clear your skin is, no matter how beautiful your face is looking, and no matter how flawless your face is looking, you still have somebody coming to you by the side advising you to get a toner. If you don't have an oily skin, you necessarily do not need a toner, if that makes any sense. So our number two would definitely be creams. You can substitute eye cream for, like, a heavy rich moisturizer that has, like, you know, caffeine, shea butter and antioxidant. This one would really, really do the job. Even better than the supposed eye cream, because you can just use this moisturizers in different ways. You can use it on your skin, you can use it on your face, you can just use it up and down, and you have nothing to worry about. That is like using one stone to kill two birds, if you get my point. So our number four will be make your own mask at home. I think I made a video about how I do my facials at home. I'll link that video down the description box, so be sure to check it out. I made my own mask with the turmeric, honey, sugar. Okay, there are so many ways to play around this mask. There are so many things, like, all these products that I mentioned, you'll not even spend up to 500 naira and you'll have your max with you. And it's not like it's something that you're going to use only once. It's some products that you'll keep and you still, you know, reuse them when necessary. So you don't necessarily need to buy a mask. You guys, I made a video about how, you know, what I use on my skin, and I could remember not showing you my mask. That is because I just do my home remedy mask. Like, I don't use any other mask. I don't get them professional masks because all those masks, they are scam. It's not like they don't work, but instead of using like buying expensive mask, you can just do this one at home and it will work even better than the one you are going to buy. So there is no point going to buy a mask when you can actually do your own at the comfort of your own home. Like, even the scrub that I showed you guys, that scrub is out. I think I threw the remaining one away. It's not like it's not good, but then I'm not going to replace it because I can actually do my scrub at home. You guys, the moment you discover all of this thing, the moment you start incorporating this into your day-to-day life, or the moment you come to the realization of all these things, you know that it's really, really important to, you know, not buy some of these things. Like, all some of these things are really, really not necessary. Another one would be, try not to always go out for a spa. Do your facials at home. Doing your facials at home just simply means that you steam at home, you boil your hot water, pour in your oil, just cover your towel, or clean white towel or any clean material that you have, cover it, let the vapor penetrate really well, after which, you know, clean your face, drop your, you know, you just have a sunscreen at home and all of those things. You don't necessarily need for go you don't necessarily need to go for a spa treatment and everything. There's another way you can actually have your spa done. Like, you pay for a package and you'll be entitled to different, you know, different packaging there. So you don't need to start going to pay for diff, like, you know, every day spa and maybe every week. There are people who do that every week, so it is really not necessary. Just have your spa done, or just have your facials done at home. Now, last but not the least for this particular video would be, you know, waxing at home. Waxing at home is even the easiest thing ever, because you don't need numerous ingredients for this. It's just sugar that you need. You know, you just melt your sugar, place it on the places you want to wax, and just then wax. It is not difficult to do that. So I see people going to pay. I know it is good to be taken care of, it is good to be pampered, like, you take yourself out, and you, yes, there are times you want to do that, but don't feel like, okay, if you don't do this there, you are not getting the professional, you know, like, treatment and everything. Don't feel like, okay, if I don't get to have my facials done at the spa, or if I don't have to, you know, wax my leg at the spa, that means I'm not doing the right thing. No, you can actually do this at the comfort of your own home. You can actually use your, what is it called, your vit to, you know, wask, you know, clean your leg and everything. So you don't necessarily need to spend all this money trying to look good. You can actually do this at the comfort of your home. And still, see, all my life, it is just once that I've gone for facials. And you guys, that was about last month. I just it was not something that I even planned. I went out to a spa. I just went there to buy one or two things, and I saw this beautiful salon, and I'm like, okay, let me enter. I asked them of their packaging, and they showed me what they had, and, you know, I opted for facials. It was 4,000, like 4,000 naira, you guys. What they did, like, I don't even know what they did, apart from the apart from the, you know, extracting my you know, apart from the extraction that they did, there's nothing special that they did. They just used a black max charcoal, they just steamed my face, and then they just use a cleanser, you know. And the kind of cleanser that they use is this baby face kind of cleanser that they even used that day. And they did it after, you know, after they finished, I came home, and like, after 2 days, I broke out really, really badly on those areas. So one negative part about, you know, having your facials done outside is that you don't know the ingredients they are going to use, especially when you don't know your skin. type. It is only when you know your skin type that if you go out, you can just tell them that, look, I have a sensitive skin, so please use products for sensitive skin, or I have a dry skin, please use products for dry skin. So if you don't tell them like that, they will just go about using, especially if they have apprentice, they will just use any kind of product on your face and you feel like, okay, they are doing the right thing. No, just try to know what is good for you, try to know what works for you, and do it at home. Okay, so yeah, this will be it for this video. I'm going to do the part two of the, in fact, if you like this video, just let me know so that I'll be doing the part two for you guys. I hope this one helps you in a way. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. Show me love on my other channel with Sunita, and Vlog with Sunita. And I'll definitely see you guys in my next one. Bye.